Good morning and welcome to Face the Nation. 2 years and 2 days ago, the WHO received the first formal word from China about a mysterious new virus circulating in Wuhan. We've made a lot of progress fighting that virus since those terrifying early days of the global pandemic, and we are learning to live with masks and restrictions designed to protect our health. But we're starting a third year of COVID with new concerns and confusion about the Omicron variant. Mark Strassman begins our COVID coverage from Atlanta.
A new year in our COVID chronicles, welcomed by maskless Floridians with this super spreaders jamboree. Risky behavior, even reckless. Like many New Year's resolutions, COVID records get broken daily.
The speed at which Omicron is spreading is staggering.
Take these jarring U.S. numbers. A new average of 356,000 new cases a day. That's four more cases every second. On Thursday, 16 states reported their highest total ever.
The numbers we're seeing, put that mask on and keep it on through January at least, honestly.
More ominously, those numbers could be fractional. Driving this epidemic, people who are undiagnosed, either asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic, but untested.
This place is so busy. It's so packed. We have patients coming in all the time.
More worry spots, hospitals overwhelmed by sick patients and sick staff.
The majority of these people are not vaccinated. I can't get them out of the frickin' waiting room. I can't get the sick people out of the waiting room to get them away from these people with COVID.
Many doctors say avoid going to the ER, often a COVID hotbed, especially for children.
If you're going to have people getting together and you have children that are unvaccinated, they will be the bullseye for, you know, for Omicron.
Across COVID America last week, almost 400 children a day were hospitalized for the virus. That's a 66% increase from the week before.
Probably seeing 4 to 5 times the number of children who are currently in my ICU.
Schools, another worry. Millions of children head back to class tomorrow. Parents spend hours in line for testing, often confused about school guidance and protocols that vary district to district, even school to school. Many parents also worry their kids are soft targets.
They got to use the same bathroom, you know, the same lunchroom, so you're still exposing back everybody to COVID.
More than 2,000 K through 12 schools have already closed or will offer remote learning. But most of America's major school systems will resume this week by teaching in person while they can.
If the teachers we have are coming down with the virus, who's going to teach the students?
Here in Georgia, testing now shows the positivity rate now pushes 40%. It's so high, Atlanta Public Schools just decided to hold virtual classes this week when the kids come back on Tuesday. Margaret?
Mark Strassman, thank you.